Hi students, good morning. Once again, welcome to Maths. This is Srinivas from Jatpetches, Dabalpur. We have been learning about surface areas and volumes of cuboid and cube. So far we have learned in the previous sessions the total surface area and lateral surface area of a cuboid, as well as the total surface area and lateral surface area of a cube, and also some example problems we have done in the previous classes. Now in this session we are going to have some more concepts about the cube and also cuboid. Okay children, are you ready to listen the class? That's good. I am going to start this class with the volume of a cuboid. Okay children, volume of a cuboid. Okay, now what is the volume of a cuboid? Let me explain clearly the volume of a cuboid. So volume of a cube and cuboid, about these both, volume of a cube and cuboid, we are going to learn today. So volume, what do you mean by volume? First of all, as we learnt in the lateral surface area and the total surface area, we have counted all the faces of a cube or a cuboid and then find out the area of each face. If it is total surface area, totally 6 faces. If it is lateral surface area, totally 4 faces except top and bottom. But here it is not like that. Volume is different from area. What do you mean by volume? That's why I gave the definition of volume also. Okay, what do you mean by volume? Amount of space occupied by a three-dimensional object is called its volume. So volume means amount of space. It is not a place. Very carefully, it is a space, it's not a place. So amount of space occupied by a three-dimensional object is called its volume. I'll explain later again by taking a diagram also. Example, volume of your geometry box is greater than the volume of the pen and eraser kept it inside it. See, you have your geometry box. In the geometry box, usually children used to keep pen, pencil, eraser, sharpener and also etc. So the geometry box has got some empty place. In that empty place, you will put this eraser, pen or pencil or something else. So that empty place keeps all the material which are outside and can be put inside. That may be pen, pencil or eraser or sharpener, anything else. So that is called the volume. That is called the volume. Okay, so empty place which is inside the box or a compass box or a geometry box or a bottle or a bucket, in that bucket we will pour water, that empty place can be filled with water. Okay, now that's called the volume. Okay, we use square units to find the area of the region, whereas we will use cubic units to find the volume of a solid. To find the volume of a solid, we use cubic units. To find the area of a region, we use square units. I'll explain you later. Square units means length and breadth. Cubic units means length, breadth, height. An object which is having length, breadth and height is called a cubic. An object which is having length and breadth is called a square. Okay, the volume of a solid is measured by counting the number of unit cubes it contains. The volume of a solid, solid in the sense a box or a brick or a Mysore pak, like that, a solid object. The volume of a solid object can be measured by counting the number of unit cubes. Now we have to count how many number of unit cubes are there. and then we can tell the volume of the of particular object. Okay, some more we'll learn about this volume. If you go to the examples and the activity, you will come to know very easily. You can understand. Okay, children. Okay, now let us see one activity. What is that activity? See, I have given a cuboid. This is a cuboid. You can recognize this. It is as a cuboid, no? So in this cuboid, I am filling this cuboid with cubes. Very carefully observe, children. I am filling this cuboid empty place with cubes. Okay, this is one cube. Next, second cube and third cube. Fourth cube, fifth cube, sixth cube, seventh cube. Are you observing, children? See, this is an empty place of this box. This box is nothing but a cuboid. In this cuboid, there is some empty place. Now I am filling this empty place with some unit cubes. These are cubes, with some unit cubes. Okay, now this is one more unit cube, one more unit cube, one more unit cube, one more unit cube. Now how many unit cubes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So half of the box is filled with unit cubes. Once more, I repeat, this unit cube is filled, this cuboid is filled with unit cubes, but not the whole empty place is filled with unit cubes, but half of the empty place only filled with unit cubes. Again, backside of this unit cubes, we can fill some more unit cubes, isn't it? So half of the cuboid only is filled with unit cubes, not full empty place is filled. Do you observe, children? Okay, half only. Now half the cuboid is filled with 15 unit cubes. How many unit cubes are required to fill the half of the cuboid? 15 unit cubes. If you want to fill the full, the remaining space is to be filled with 15 more unit cubes. So the remaining also we need 15 more unit cubes. Then the whole cuboid will be filled with unit cubes if you take 15 more unit cubes. Understood? So total unit cubes required to fill the this cuboid is, so to fill this cuboid we need the total unit cubes 15 plus 15, 30 unit cubes we need, isn't it, children? Yes, we need 30 unit cubes. Now understand properly, how do you get that 30? See, this is length of a cuboid, this is breadth of a cuboid, and this is height of a cuboid. In the length, okay, how many cubes, unit cubes are required to fill this length? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. To fill this height, 1, 2, 3. Okay, 5, and this is 3. 5 threes. And breadth, how many cubes we need? 2 cubes we need. This is 2. These are 5. And this breadth side, 2 cubic units. And this height side, 3 cubic units. 5, 2, 3. Okay, now you can understand. See the next slide. Then you will easily understand. Can you count these cubes? Can you count these cubes? Can you count? See, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is length side. Breadth side, 1, 2, 3. Breadth side is 3. Height side, 1, 2, 3. Height is 3. This is unit cube. So we have to treat it as 1 centimeter or 1 unit. This is 1 unit and 1, and this is 1 and this is 1. So length side totally 1, 1, 1, 1. Totally 4. Breadth is 3 and height is 3, isn't it? Length is 4 units, breadth is 4 units, height is 4 units. So see, length is 4 units, this is 4, next breadth is 3 units, and height is 3 units. Now we need to find out total cubes. The total cubes are, this is 4, this is 3, and height is 3. 4 into 3 into 3, 4 threes are 12, 12 threes are 24. So how many cubes are existed in this cuboid? Totally 24 cubes are existed in this cuboid. Now how to establish a formula to find out a cuboid? See, how to establish a formula to find out a cuboid? Take this total cubes 24, this is nothing but the volume. Total, this cuboid is filled with 24 unit cubes, so it is filled totally. That is why that is called the volume. So 24 is the volume. Now take the 24, volume of a cuboid is 24. Now take the 24, this 24 can be written as 4 into 3 into 3, isn't it? That means 4 length, 3 breadth, and 3 height. So this 24 is, can be written as L into B into H. But what is this 24 represents? Volume of a cuboid. So volume of a cuboid is equal to length into breadth into height. That is what we can establish a formula from this activity. Okay, so volume of a cuboid is equal to length into breadth into height. Like that we can establish a formula from this cuboid. Do you understand, children? Did you listen carefully? Did you observe carefully? Did you count these cubes, all the unit cubes? Very good, that's good. Like that you have to listen any lesson, not only maths, for any lesson you have to listen very carefully and observe very carefully, so that you can learn very easily. Okay children, next let us go to the next slide. This is I have given you some homework. Try this. What is this? Come on, see. This is a cuboid. It's not a cube. 3. This is 3 length, and the breadth is 6, and the height is 3. Now you have to try for this one. How many? What is the length? What is the breadth? And what is the volume? How can you find out everything? How can you find out the volume of this cuboid? All these you have to find out at home. Okay, count properly length, breadth, height. Next, let us see another problem. Find the volume of the given cuboid. Now here one cuboid will be given. Find that volume. I'll give a cuboid. See, this is a cuboid. Okay, can you see the cuboid, children? Very good. Now this length, breadth, and height are already represented. You need not count also. This is very easy. Length is 3, breadth is 3, height is 4. Very easy. Already it is given length, breadth, and height. Now it is easy to find out the volume of a cuboid. Already we have got a formula for volume of a cuboid now. So let us take the formula and then substitute. You will get the answer. First of all, let us write the dimensions of a cuboid. What are the dimensions of a cuboid? Dimensions in the sense length, breadth, height. Take length L, 3 cm, and breadth B, also 3 cm. This is length and this is breadth. And height H is equal to 4 cm. Now volume of a cuboid formula, V is equal to LBH. This is volume of a cuboid. So substitute LBH, then V is equal to L3B3H3. Very easy. Now multiply all these 3. 3 into 3 into 4. 3 threes are 9. 9 fours are 36. So V is equal to 36 cubic centimeter. See, what an easy problem it is. volume of a cuboid, if you have a formula, V is equal to L into B into H. Such an easy problem. So, dear children, I hope you understand well. So, volume of a cuboid is equal to V is equal to L in 36 cubic centimeters. Okay, children, that's good. I hope you understood very well this class also. Keep watching my classes always. Maths is very easy if you watch carefully and properly. This is Srinivas from ZPHS Doublepur. Thank you, children. Thank you so much. Now I remain. Okay, children. Thank you.